Hi there, and thanks for taking time to have a look at this quick demo on how the new digital filing cabinet that we have built into the mydaEs works. So the idea here is that all paper documents relating to a production can be scanned in and stored within the software itself, so it can be easily and quickly found throughout the life of the production and for many years to come, without having to carry all those big files around. So without further ado, let me take you on a quick tour on how this works in practice. Well, let's minimize that for a second. So if I open up all my invoices that I got in the mail today, I just put them together in a big pile, and then I put them on my sheet feed scanner, and I just hit scan, and it scans them in as one big document. If you are a user of a flatbed scanner, then this will be a bit painful for you, and I would suggest that you need a sheet feed scanner so that you can go make coffee while it scans all your documents. Then here you got the file that I have created this morning. And in here you can see I have my three invoices. I don't actually care about the file name or anything like that that my scanner gives, because the software will sort that out for me. So what I need to do to make the software use it, I have a little folder here which I have told the software all about, where I have all the different in trays. So my AP, my accounts payable in tray, my filing tray for the accounts payable, my journals, petty cash, POs, and payroll. So this one here is invoices I've done, so it needs to go into AP, so I just drag it into the AP like that, and there we go. Now I jump into the program and go into accounts payable to enter these invoices. Normally just enter invoices, but here we're entering them from the in tray. So click on there. First time when it sees this document, it's going to ask, would I like to split the document into individual pages? As I have three invoices on this one, yes, I would like it to do that. So what happens now is, on the left you can see the invoice, on the right you can see the invoice entry screen. If you have a big screen like mine, or multiple screens even, you can change these around to make it bigger or smaller to make it work for you. So you can then, you see the first invoice up here that I can then start entering. I'm just going to show you another little feature. If this is not the one I want to start with for some reason, I can, down here I can skip the file. So it will skip the file, put it at the bottom of the pile, and bring the next one available to me. So if I go in here and do GPS, and oh, that's SP, fine, that's the wrong one, so it's not the one I wanted. I wanted GPS, GPS systems. If it wasn't available, if I was to type in something that was not available, like that, it'll bring up here a selection for a creditor, and in here I can just click on new, and then I can go in and start typing GPS systems. It's already in there, so I won't bother, and then it'll create creditor code, and you can fill in all details directly from the invoice on the left hand side here. One little feature I would like to just show is when you go adding the default account codes, if you just tab through there, it'll come up with a list here. GPS would be something to do with computing. If you know approximately where the account number is, you can type in the account number here. So for example, 4, it'll bring up all the 4s for you, whatever. I think it's something to do with computing, I don't know. Oh, there you go, computing, computer box rentals. Just click on that and it'll put that account in as your default account for it. So I'm just going to do, no thank you, I don't want to save that one there. And up here I'm just going to put GPS, it's in there already, invoice number, we already entered that, so here we go, enter the amount, and then it's a GPS system, and as you can see it's picked up stunts from when I picked up the wrong creditor code, so here I'm just going to delete that out there, and I want to pick the computer code again, which was that one there. And then you do no VAT on that one there, 0, there you go. So we now have that one there, and then when I click save, it'll automatically attach this invoice to this invoice in the system, and I'll ask if you want to create another one. I don't really want to create another one just now, because you don't need to see me do it all over again. Now if you go into accounts payable and then find transactions, this is where we can go and look for anything in the system by creditor code or anything else, or I can just bring up all invoices, and we have all invoices here, and we can see that's the one I've just entered now, and it's got a little paperclip attached, which means that the scan has been attached. As you can see, transaction 24 here does not have a paperclip. So if that's the case, then what you could do is we've obviously entered it already, and then under scans we've got AP filing, so that's where I would put all the ones which I know have been entered in the system but haven't been attached to the system yet. So I just put them in here, and then when I go into accounts payable to the filing, because we're not entering the invoice, it's already been entered, it'll bring up anything that I have in my filing folder that I just showed you. And it was that one there, I think, we were playing with. And then you just click on File down here at the bottom. And then it says there are no more. And it does that because every time you do any of these filings or anything like that, it moves them out of the folder and into the process folder. So that means that you know if there's anything left in here, it hasn't been done yet, hasn't been actioned yet. And if there isn't, then you're finished with all those actions. If we then go in to post our invoices, we'll just post these two invoices here. 24 and 25. It's asking if I'd like to do a posting report. No, thank you, not today. That's all done. And then we go to the little magnifying glass up here, which is the powerful find command that we have in the system. This gives us the ability to find anything posted into the system. So you can then sort by transaction number, by account number, or even by creditor code down here, or by currency if you know what sort of transaction you're looking for. We're going to be looking for our invoices, so I'm going to pick my source box up here and just go to invoices, and I'm just going to click OK, and that will bring up all the invoices. As you can see, they're all a little bit all over the place with the numbers. So what you can do is all of these headings at the top are something you can sort under. So if I just click on transaction number, you'll see it'll sort it straight in transaction number order. If you've got a whole page or more than a page, you don't want to scroll and you're looking for the latest transaction numbers, you just click on it again and it'll sort it the other way. So now there we can see is the last ones we've added in here. And you can see you've got little paper clips out here. The paper clips means that we have got something attached to it, and it's a nice way to make sure that we have supporting documentation for all the things we've entered in the system. So if I right click on it, you'll see it'll come up and you can now see the naming convention system is applied. It's put in the creditor code in here, the invoice number, transaction number, and a date. So you don't have to worry about anything to do with the naming convention of the PDFs. The system will do it for us. If you then click on it, nice feature here, we'll then bring it up so you can then see exactly what it was we had entered. And that is basically all you need to do for your entering from intrays or filing on your AP. We have the same features for your purchase orders and for your journals and for your petty cash. So all of those things that you do, you can enter, and you just need to put them in the right filing tray in here, and then the system will pick them up for you.